response, we determined there was a shooter on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay. Officers responded to that location and engaged the suspect at that location. He is dead currently. So there is no conspiracy between the FBI, between LVMPD and the MGM. Nobody is attempting to hide anything reference this investigation. The response, we determined there was a shooter on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay. Officers responded to that location and engaged the suspect at that location. He is dead currently. Additionally, anybody that may have cell phone video or any type of video associated with this event that would be a benefit to the investigation, please respond to the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department headquarters at 400 South Martin Luther King, and we will take custody of that video. So if you have it, you evaluate it, and you think it would be a benefit, please bring that down to the headquarters. There's been multiple phone calls and accusations or conjecture coming through social media that there's multiple shooters at other resorts. That has been proven to be false. Additionally, there has been accusations or beliefs there's some explosives going off. That is also false. The only explosive contained in this event was from our SWAT team breaching the room. So please, we are pretty confident that there is no longer a threat.
Clip after clip, bullets.
Response, we determined there was a shooter on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay. Officers responded to that location and engaged the suspect at that location. He is dead currently. So there is no conspiracy between the FBI, between LVMPD and the MGM. Nobody is attempting to hide anything reference this investigation. The dynamics and the size of this investigation requires us to go through voluminous amounts of information in order to draw an accurate picture. My intent, like I stated earlier, is to give you information as I know it, unverified, to calm the public. It's important that you continue to listen to me. 959 is important. It wasn't inaccurate when I provided to you. The circumstances associated with it is inaccurate. Okay? I am very well aware of the MGM statement provided yesterday. I agree with their statement. I'm not in conflict with their statement. But here's what I will tell you. We were provided the time of 2159 as a human entry into a security log. Through investigation, we have determined that Mr. Campos had encountered the barricaded door adjacent to the suspect's door at approximately 2159. In his attempt to gain entry to the 32nd floor, he required him to ascend to another level and eventually make access to the 32nd floor. He went to the doorway that he was dispatched to originally to address the open doorway. He mitigated that situation and subsequently received fire from the suspect. When you culminate that timeline associated from the initial 2159 to the 2205 timeline that we are still stand by as the initial volley of fire, Mr. Campos received his wounds in close proximity to 2205. He attempted to relay that information via his radio, and it was confirmed because he also relayed that information via his cell phone. So the timeline associated to both of those sources have been verified. 2205, the number that was provided earlier, referenced the majority of fire upon our community. We still stand by that time, and that was done by the combination of different sources that I listed for you earlier. 2217, 12 minutes. That is when our officers first arrived on the 32nd floor. 12 minutes. You are very well aware the suspect fired at approximately 10 minutes. Upon our arrival on the 32nd floor, the firing had ceased. We did not believe we had continually had an active shooter. At that point, we conducted evacuations of the rooms adjacent to the suspect's room, and you know the rest. So there is no conspiracy between the FBI, between LVMPD and the MGM. Nobody is attempting to hide anything reference this investigation.
One 6 9 10 means we got shots fired. 4:15 a.m. at the Route 91. Sounded like an automatic firearm. We have an active shooter. We have an active shooter inside the fairgrounds.
I can't see anything.
Stay in here. Stay in here.
No, stay here. No, 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 no.
Stay here.
I need security. Where's security?
You guys stay in here.
I am in the casino, babe.
No, they're 32.
32?
Yeah, 32, 32.
32. Okay.
Do we have access to get into that room?
What do you want to do? You want to make entry? We're going to have to.
We're going to have to, yeah. I think everybody else is pinned outside.
I don't know. I don't know if it's a pellet or a 22 or...
Do we have access to this room?
The double doors on the very 3 feet.
Right,
clear, let's move back. We'll clear left and then we'll go up.
And all I could hear was automatic gunfire over the radio.
Okay. You guys with him, go to the stairwell.
We had thousands of people that were getting shot at, and I knew that we couldn't get them aid until I made this room safe. So unfortunately, that's a risk that we had to take. We didn't really discuss it, we just did it.
Okay, I'm gonna hold on this door, okay?
But I think, you know, when you're in that moment, you focus on what needs to be done. And we all knew what needed to be done.
We hung breeches on the door. I covered him. He hung the breech. We backed up into the small area on the stairwells that we were staged, and we then blew the door.
We didn't know who was in that room, who was behind that door. We just knew that there were so many incidents going on down on the strip that we had to take care of this problem here.
And I could see a big rifle just past the door on the ground. So I called that out to Levi. He was low, I was high. I had a rifle, he had his, and we're looking through the door and we're kind of calling out some of the stuff that we could see initially. And then we made the decision to make entry.
Okay, cover on that. In with you, with you, with you.
And I knew at that point in time it was pivotal for us. And it was a game changer for us to do what we did.
Everybody back out. Coming out. Coming out.